Hello and welcome back everyone. So there are some basic requirements that need to be fulfilled before performing a surgery. Now this can be any surgery, whether it be an oral maxillofacial surgery or neurosurgery or any other, but the basic requirements stay the same. These two principal requirements are adequate visibility and proper assistance. So let's briefly discuss each one of them. So adequate visibility may seem too obvious for everyone, but it is often overlooked by many surgeons. Adequate visibility depends on three factors. The first one is adequate access. So for a dentist, adequate access may only mean how well the patient can open their mouth. But often during surgery, increased access must be created in order to have a better exposure of the site and the problem at hand. Like during an extraction of an impacted tooth, a dentist cannot view the tooth by simply opening the patient's mouth. He needs to open a flap in order to have adequate access to the impacted tooth. And hence, in this case, increased access is surgically created. Proper retraction of soft tissues of the oral cavity is also a crucial part of providing access, and retraction of the tissue also protects them from being accidentally injured from any sharp instrument. Improved access during oral surgery, as already discussed, is often created by giving flaps, and the topic of flap will be discussed in detail in my further video. So the next factor for improved visibility is having an adequate light source during surgery. Adequate light is another very obvious requirement for a surgery. However, often during complex surgeries, the surgeon or the assistant are often placed in such positions that may accidentally block the light. Therefore, the light source must continuously be repositioned either by the dentist or by the assistant. Ideally, the use of more than one light or using an overhead light greatly improves illumination and must be used in complex surgeries. The final factor for having improved visibility is having a surgical field free of excess blood or any other fluids or debris. This is important so that the surgeon can easily perform his surgery without having to constantly wipe off the blood and remove the debris. High volume suctioning with a small tip can easily be used to remove excess blood and fluid from the surgical field. So these were the factors required for adequate visibility. So the next principal requirement of performing a successful oral surgery is having a properly trained assistant. So having a trained assistant is very crucial for the success of a surgery. The assistant should be familiar with the instrument being used as well as the procedure being performed in order to act swiftly during surgery according to the surgeon's need. A successful surgery is very difficult to accomplish with poor or no assistance. Hence, the surgeon should always keep a well-trained assistant by his side during any complex or simple surgery. So this was a brief lecture on basic requirements of a surgery. So I will be making further videos in which I will discuss more about the other basic principles of oral surgery. You can even visit my blog studywiththedentist.com where you can read more on this topic. Till then, stay safe, take care of yourselves and your loved ones, and goodbye.